What is up, everyone? It is Speed here, and today we're going to be talking about three tips for cores. If you're a core player and you want to get better, I'm going to be listing off three things you need to be doing or thinking about right now to get to the next level. So if you guys are excited for that, click the like button and subscribe for more Dota 2 content. And now that we've gotten the intro out of the way, I also want to say that you guys should subscribe to the Game Leap website. Why? Because recently, I know you're already like, skip. No, because, guys, just yesterday, I made a video on how I review my replays. Now, I know you're like, oh, Speed, that's so boring. Well, I agree. So this is really only going to be tailored to the people who actually care about Dota, who actually care about getting better, because I know a lot of people are here to have fun and chill, and that's fine. You know, you could listen to my videos for whatever reason you want. I'm cool with that. But if you're trying to get to the next level, I have an entire video now that I just made that talks about how I review replays, what I look for, what I do after I review the replay, basically everything you need to know about just learning the game of Dota very, very quickly and in depth. So yeah, if you're interested in that, click the link down below to go check out that video on how I review my replays if you're trying to get much, much better at Dota, as that's extremely advanced concepts. Now let's get into the video. So number one, the first tip is that your actions dictate your team's actions. What I mean by this is that whatever you do as a carry, very often your team will follow behind. And I know I'm hearing a lot of, especially the SEA comment section, already coming in saying, Speed, no matter what I do, my team doesn't listen. No one listens to me. It basically is like I'm a ghost. Guys, I want you to look at your games as a carry player, okay? If you don't do this, you're not allowed to comment. You're not allowed to. No, but in all seriousness, look at your games and watch them. And go high ground. When you go high ground, look what your team does. When you dive, look what your team does. You're often gonna notice that, oddly enough, they are doing basically whatever you're doing. If you're going high ground, they're going high ground. If you are going Roche, they're going Roche. Sure, it might take them 20, 30 seconds to get there, but you know, if you're diving high ground, they're gonna come with you basically immediately, assuming you're in position. Because people look at their carry, the person who dictates the fight, the initiator, and they follow it up. If you lead, people follow. That's how humans work. That's how we work. So you have to take advantage of the fact that as the strongest hero on the map, whether or not you're the mid laner, off laner, or safe laner, this applies to you, right? What you do enables your team, and you can use this in very effective ways. If you don't believe me, fine, just skip to the next part of the video. I understand a lot of people are just too close-minded to accept that their actions actually can dictate their teams. But if you believe that this might be true, well, listen to my next part. So an advanced way you can use this is, let's say, you know, you just learned about farming aggressively. You're starting to understand that pushing in waves and pushing waves very deep onto the enemy side of the map, right, getting onto the enemy side of the map and farming and then placing aggressive vision is one of the best ways to take away farm from the enemy team and amplify your own farm. It's a very high MMR concept that very often you need teammates' helps to do. Not always, actually. I recommend if you are a core player, just as a side note, to farm more aggressively, be less afraid of dying. Death is not a big deal, even in Dota. Like, you need to die over and over again to practice these things. But getting back onto the point, what you're gonna realize is if you farm very aggressively top for a while, and if you really want to speed up the process, tell your team, hey guys, come up here. But very often, if you farm top, like super deep their side of the map, in their jungle, your team will eventually shift themselves towards you. I'm serious. You should try it out if you don't believe me, right? You can give it a shot. You can come back to this video and say, Speed, you're terribly wrong. Or Speed, wow, you're such a genius. I love you. Take all my money. Like the video. Nah, but in all seriousness, give that a shot, guys. The next point I'm going to give you guys is a very difficult one for a lot of people to hear. This is pretty brutal. It's pretty broken tip, but I'm serious. I think it's true. But the point is that mechanical skill, right, how well you click your buttons, and farming speed dictates MMR growths up until like the 4k MMR bracket, at least. Like, I would even argue it can be to 5k. And sure, like, information and knowledge is important. Dota is a game of knowledge. But once you have the baseline knowledge that you can get from videos like mine, or just really anywhere at this point, there's so many videos on just how to play Dota correctly. Once you have that proper knowledge, right, once you've built up the knowledge from a video like this, then it just comes to applying it and really paying attention to how fast you can click your buttons, how fast you can farm. And I'm going to ask you guys a lot of questions, and these are the important questions of Dota. These are the ones you should focus on, not like bizarre item builds and like weird fight locations and all this either complex or unnecessary stuff that does not affect how quickly you gain MMR. These are the important questions you should ask yourself, okay? Number one, do you win easy lanes? So in the laning stage, do you win the easy lanes? Win the easy lanes, not go even, win. When you're playing Slark against, I don't know, Tidehunter, do you win? Do you win? And do you go even in hard ones? When it seems like a near impossible lane, and I get comments like this all the time, where people DMing me, Speed, I had this impossible lane I couldn't do anything about. And then, there's so many of these. Yes, there are difficult lanes. There's lanes you seemingly can do nothing about, but there are steps you can take to make the lane better. That is what people just do not consider or do not even think about. How can you guys not get this? Or certain people not get this? There are things you can do to make the lane better. Number one, creep aggro. Number two, mirroring the position four. Number three, pulling. Number four, buying regen. Number five, buying proper stat items. If you do these things and you do them consistently, not, oh, I pulled the creep aggro once, is that good enough, Speed? Or, oh, my support pulled the lane once, is that good enough? Or, my support won't pull, so I can't win the lane. No, you go do the pull. Just do these things, guys. Think about them. Be critical on yourself. Look at your replay. I know no one wants to do that, but look at your game and actually be harsh on yourself. Or just pay attention to your match. Are you pulling creep aggro 80 times in a laning stage or 50 times in a laning stage? Right? Maybe it doesn't have to be that much, but you guys get the point. The second is, do you farm fast? Do you hit timings faster than everyone else in your lobby? Are you top net worth every game? Number three is, do you identify open waves? Are you constantly just running around and hitting only jungle creeps and just fighting all the time? Or are you pushing waves extremely deep because you saw that the enemy team was top, you pushed a bottom wave even though it was at their bottom tier 2 tower? Do you do these things? Do you identify the open wave immediately? Not after 5 seconds, not after 10 seconds, immediately do you see the open wave based on minimap vision. Number 4. Do you jump the correct targets in fights? Are you jumping people you can't kill or people who can kill you? Do you purchase the right items? Do you farm effective areas? And do you show up to dives? And what I mean by do you show up to dives is when people are diving your team at a tier 1 or tier 2 tower, you can show up, even as a carry player. These are the best fights in Dota. When the enemy team is diving a tower, these are the best fights to show up to, and I highly suggest you do. And finally, last but not least, we have copy exactly what the pros do. Now, this is something I say in a lot of my videos, but I really want to stress it one more time. Why? Because this is how I got to 7k MMR. I'm serious. Most of the things, or most of the information I have, and the information that I'm providing to you guys, while a lot of it is critical thinking on my behalf, I would say the majority are ideas from other people or me theory crafting with other players. It's not just what comes up in my head. I don't have some insane ego. That's why I, on the Game Leap Discord, if I talk to people, I'm willing to listen to what you have to say. If I think you're brutally wrong and you're griefing yourself, I will tell you. But if I think you say something that is different or new or something I haven't heard of, right? I am super open-minded to that because you have to get rid of your ego and be willing to say, maybe I'm not always right. Maybe I'm not always right. I can have wrong ideas. That is what Dota is all about, saying, basically trying to become less wrong over time, gathering new ideas that are more reliable over time. Just drop your ego and be willing to listen to people. It can go as far as, even when I am and you guys are getting flamed in solo queue, you are willing to take the criticism, because sometimes it's ridiculous and when people are just calling you all sorts of words, you know, whatever racial slur it is for the week, like, that doesn't matter, okay? That you can just push it, mute them, move on. Right? But if someone tells you, hey, you should have made this play, or you should have cast your dispel here, instead of immediately going, oh, no, not me, I'm so perfect, not me. No, like, maybe it is you. Like, you know what I mean? All I'm trying to say is that listening is one of the best ways to learn in Dota, because it is way too complex of a game for you to learn everything by yourself. You can't just think of everything. That's ridiculous, right? And that's why, even in these videos, I'm willing to talk to you guys in the comments or in Discord DMs about the things I talk about. If you guys disagree, that's fine. Like, that's fine. A long time ago, when all the new ags came up for carries, like, there was ags on troll and ags on PA, and I'm like, these are all trash. And people were like, you don't understand the implications of them, Speed. And I was willing to, even though I thought it was brutally wrong, I was like, no one is ever gonna buy ags on troll. To be fair, I was actually somewhat wrong about ags on PA. I said it would never be purchased. It got purchased a couple times. but ags on troll, I haven't seen that once. But people were very angry at me. That video got an obscene amount of dislikes. People were extremely mad that I said that these new ags were not viable, like a lot of them. So mad. But that's okay. That's fine, because that's why I like Dota, because we can disagree about the game. And that's all I'm trying to say. Take what the pros do, and don't be so uptight about your own ideas, right? Really try to pay attention to what other people do. Listen to what I have to say. Don't get mad about it, all right? This is a game I've studied for 6 years now, about. I've probably watched like 2,000 replays at this point. It's an insane amount of learning, and all I'm trying to do is help you guys get better. So when I go on the gaming Discord and someone gets mad, and like you guys get mad about certain ideas that I talk about, or you get angry that I gave you criticism, it's insane to me. It's insane to me. Like, it's literally insane. If I had the opportunity to learn from a 7K player when I was 2K, I would just listen and try to implement. Once again, I'm not trying to make this about an ego battle. I'm not. I'm just trying to get you on the right page as soon as possible. And that is why I recommend you go to a pro match, you copy them to the best of your ability. You might be like, well, Speed, if I'm watching a pro match, I can't even understand what they're doing. Try to take everything you can out of it. When you take the things you can out of it, you're gonna realize that is what you should focus on, because the things that you currently know about, you should fix first. And then when eventually you hit an MMR plateau, after you've mastered the fundamentals that you've understood, you can move on to listening to new higher MMR concepts, or you can sign up for GameLeap.com. That is where I'm gonna end the video. Thank you guys for watching. I hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you in the next one. Peace.
Before you leave, just want to say a quick message. If you're trying to get better at Dota or you just enjoyed that video, I know this is pretty general and you're going to hear this quite a bit from me, but I recommend you sign up to GameLeap.com. Why? Because I put a lot of effort into the content over there, and generally the effort I do there is different from the content you're going to see here on YouTube. It is different. In fact, I usually go a lot more in depth on topics or into niche topics that help you get to the next level even faster, because on YouTube, I often have to keep it more mainstream, and that's even why I'm putting it at the end of this YouTube video. That's why this is at the end, because a lot of people just watch 5 minutes, they skip through just for like the dopamine spike. But if you are interested in actually getting better at Dota, I recommend you go to the description down below, get your discount right now by clicking the link, sign up, use the discount code that you're gonna see there, and I hope to see you there right now. So click it, and yeah, thanks for watching.